The push operation adds an item in the stack. If the stack is overflowed with the elements, it's called as overflow condition. Pop removes an item from the stack. That means if you delete an element from the memory, it's a pop operation. The items are popped in the reverse order in which they are pushed. Like if you are inputting the elements, if you are inputting these elements, that is 10, 80 and 70, you are going to input the number, you are going to push the number 70, 80 and 10 in this manner using push method, and this becomes the top element at this position. If you remove 10, this becomes the topmost element. If you remove this also, top will be set to -1. That means stack is empty. Insertion and deletion at the top of the stack only. Initially, when the stack is empty, top equal to -1. For push operation, find the value of top, which is increased by 1, and then the new element is pushed at the position of the top. See, this is the formula for, this is the method for creating a stack variable, stack class name. You are creating new object for the stack class. This is the constructor method. You are pushing the elements by using the dot operator and a new object created, that is ST. 1, 2 and 3. 1, 2 and 3, these are the elements that you need to push inside. By making use of the for each loop, the objects or the elements which are pushed or stack elements is going to be printed. In the fourth step, we can count the number of elements inside the stack, and this contains method will display the element which you are searching for. This is the program for inserting the elements, removing the elements. After removing the element which is at the topmost level or at any desired location, eshtu elements remaining irutte stack alli, ee riti output barutte. For that you have this program. Initially there is a declaration of the variable top. And variable max is set to 1000. This is the new object with respect to max. Bool is empty. Is empty method is declared with the variable bool. Top less than 0, if it's empty, it will return this result. If it's greater than or equal to this max position, stack overflow anta display agutte. Set stack top element with the data which you are inserting. Pop out the stack element. Enu elements illa andre stack underflow condition. If the elements inside the stack is less than 0, else decrement the value. Peek function will return the topmost element of the stack. Push pop jethege peek anta irutte that we have used in the program. If top is less than 0, stack underflow condition. Otherwise, it will print the peek function will print the topmost element. Pop function. If you remove all the elements from stack, stack underflow. Otherwise, it is able to remove the elements from the stack. Push function fits the topmost element. It's greater than or equal to the maximum element that is being set. It will display stack overflow. Otherwise, it will keep on accepting the elements that you are inputting and it will return the result. See here, you can observe the plus plus or the increment operator for inputting the values or the elements inside the stack. This decrement operator for removing the elements from the stack. Print stack function will check stack underflow. It will print this message. This is a display function. If there are no elements in the stack, it will print this message, else items in the stack are as follows. I equal to top, I greater than or equal to 0, I will be decremented. It will display the elements from the topmost element. That's why I is set to top. From the top element, topmost element, the pointer will come down. That's why I is set to greater than or equal to 0. And it will keep on decrementing the index positions of stack. That's why we have I minus minus in for loop. All the elements, remaining elements after doing all this pushing, popping and peak operations, the remaining elements will be displayed in the print stack element. This is how you can implement the stack concept in C#. You have three methods: pushing, popping, peek to check the topmost element, and display. For displaying the elements in the stack, you have print stack here. And the main class, that is the class program, will push the elements 10, 20, 30 and 40. My stack is the object created for the class stack. MyStack.printStack method will print all the elements. This printStack method is not here. PrintStack method this code execution. PrintStack method call adaga. This stack will store all these elements. Next line is here. Object.printStack. Dot print stack means id call agutte. Call adaga less than 0 idiyanta check madute. No, it's not less than zero because we have elements here that is being pushed. Underflow condition illa, so it needs to display the items inside this stack. That you can view here. Items in this stack or from the topmost element print agutte anta helthe agle 40, 30, 20, 10. Topmost element in the stack is 40. This is for peak function. Peak function check maadide 40 topmost element anta. Item popped from the stack 40. Items in the stack iga eshtu remaining ide 40 pop maadidre. Iga next coding alli nodana topmost element to pop aagbeku. That means remove aagbeku. 30, 20 and 10. These are the remaining elements inside the stack. So because of that method, print stack idina print maadide. My stack dot peak method, next to peak method call agutte. Adikke nimge alli 40 topmost element anta print aagittu. Yakandre next line after the print stack call method call aadmele peak method call agutte. This peak method will print this topmost element in this list. Next to console.writeline method, item popped from stack, mystack.pop method, idu call agutte pop method. Pop method to topmost element in the remove maadkolta barutte elements na. So item popped from stack, which is at this position, mystack.pop function. Item pop out admele from this stack remaining elements matte print stack function call agi remaining elements sit. Thank you all.